Hello everyone, welcome back to another lecture of process modeling and simulation. I am your course instructor engineer Mohammad Haris Humayun, and the module which we are covering today is related to the unit process modeling. We have already simulated mixer and stream splitter in our previous exercise as well, and our this exercise is related to the simulation of flash separator, and there are two exercises related to the flash separator simulation. So let's go to the activity and see what are the simulation requirements and how we can simulate it to generate our required results. So there are two objectives of this simulation. Number one is recognize the way of using flash separation in Aspen Plus, knowing how to model single stage distillation which operate as ideal stage using flash. So this flash separator basically represents the single stage of a distillation column, but I will discuss it in detail when we will start the distillation in Aspen Plus. So this activity is again related with CLO number 1 and CLO number 2, as I have discussed before, that choosing the property package, choosing the components is related to the fundamentals, and simulating the equipment is related to the CLO number 2. So the problem description is that find the composition of vapor phase and liquid phase of benzene toluene mixer at 0.5 bar with specific composition using SRK property. And if you remember, for SRK property, we use steam NBS as free water method. 2000 kg per hour of feed is supplied at 70 degree centigrade and consists of 50 weight percent of benzene and 50 weight percent of toluene. Means we have been given mass flow, temperature, the composition, which are in mass basis, and the feed pressure is at 1 bar and the flash separator pressure is at 0.5 bar. And remember that the degree of freedom for this flash separator is 2, means we have to specify the two components in order to converge or simulate this flash separator. Kaun se do components aapne specify karne? There are four options available in flash separator. Number one is temperature, pressure, duty, and vapor fraction. Out of these four parameters, you have to specify two parameters. So one of the parameter which we have been specified is pressure, and the other parameter will be the same as that of the feed temperature. So what you do, simply add these components, SRK, steam, NBS, and then go to the simulation, add the flash separator, give the connections. One is the feed and two outlet stream. This one is the vapor stream and this one is the liquid stream. Give the values of the feed stream, 70 degree centigrade, 1 bar, 2000 kg per hour with mass fraction of benzene and toluene as 0.5. Then go to the flash and enter the value of temperature and pressure. Temperature value is 70 degree centigrade, pressure value is 0.5. And after that, run it. And after running it, you see that benzene and toluene are separated in the liquid. The mass fraction of benzene is 0.38 and the mass fraction of toluene is 0.62, while in top product the mass fraction of benzene is 0.64 approximately, while that of toluene is approximately 0.36. And once you go to this flash separator results, means click on results, you see the outlet temperature is 70 degree centigrade, outlet pressure 70, vapor fraction is 0.47. It means flashing has been occurred, or the flash phenomena has taken place in this flash separator, and the heat duty is 24283.2 calories, or you can convert it to the kilowatt as well. So let's go to Aspen Plus and simulate the flash separator over there. So we will add benzene, toluene, and SRK with steam TA replaced by steam NBS because we have already discussed it. Go to next, estimate missing parameter using Unifag, click next, run analysis and results available. Go to the simulation, and in separators, this flash 2 is basically your flash separator. Click it, place it over here, name it as flash, and you can enlarge it as well using this red and do the required connections of feed stream. Feed required one or more, so you will label it as feed. This one is the vapor required, label it as vapor. This is the liquid required, so you will label it as liquid. Now give the values of feed stream, that is 70 degree centigrade, 1 bar with mass value as 2000 kg per hour and the mass fraction 0.5 for benzene and 0.5 for toluene. After that, click on either flash separator or click next button and you will go to the flash. And now you have to specify the two values as we have discussed: temperature due to vapor fraction, pressure due to vapor fraction. So you have to specify in this case temperature and pressure. Temperature is 70 degree centigrade and pressure is 0.5 bar. So once after giving these values, click run, and once after running, the results are available. So how to access these results? Click on flash, right click it, go to stream results, and you see that the feed temperature is 70 degree centigrade with feed pressure as 1 bar. Vapor temperature is 70 degree centigrade with its pressure as 0.5 bar, and same is the case for liquid. So if you have this diagram only, and if you have been asked to give ke aap ye bataye ki aapne flash separator mein kaun si condition use ki hai, agar main aapko simple ye diagram dun, agar main aapko itni diagram de deta hu aur main kehta hu mujhe is diagram ko dekh kar bataye ki aapne flash mein kaun si conditions use ki hai, to aap kya karenge? Aap dekhenge vapor aur liquid mein kya temperature pressure condition hai, kyunki vapor ki bhi wahi temperature pressure conditions hongi, लिक्विड की भी वही टेम्परेचर प्रेशर कंडीशंस होंगी। तो इसका मतलब है कि ये जो दो वैल्यूज हैं यही आपकी फ्लैश सेपरेटर की स्पेसिफिकेशंस थी। और अगर मैं आपसे पूछूं फीड की क्या कंडीशन है, तो वो ऑब्वियसली ये कंडीशन हो, लेकिन आप लोगों ने ये देख लेना है कि उसके ऊपर फीड ही लिखा हुआ है। अगर यहाँ लिक्विड है, यहाँ वेपर है, यहाँ फीड है, तो फिर फीड ये है और लिक्विड वेपर ये है। सिमिलरली यू गो टू मैस फ्लोस, देन यू सी दैट द फीड मैस फ्लो रेट वाज 2000 केजी पर आवर with vapor mass flow rate as 931.545 kg per hour with mass flow of liquid as 1068.45. And if I ask that what is the flow rate of benzene in the top product, then it is 593.53. What is the flow rate of toluene in top product? It is 338 kg per hour. Similarly, the mass flow rate of benzene in bottom and toluene in bottom. Similarly, I can ask mole flow rates in kg mole per hour. That I give you this diagram and I ask what is the mass flow rate or what is the mole flow rate of benzene, or if I ask you to calculate the mass fraction, how will you calculate the mass fraction? You already know ki total flow rate jitna hota hai, for example 1068.45 hai. Agar main aapse kehta hu ki mass fraction nikale toluene ki, to aap kya karenge? 661.984 ko 1068.45 se divide kar denge, wo aapki mass fraction value aa jayegi. Similarly, aap से पूछा जाएगा अगर बेंजीन की मैस फ्रैक्शन क्या है, तो आप क्या करेंगे कि जितना मैस फ्लो रेट है बॉटम में उसको उसके टोटल मैस से डिवाइड कर दें। सिमिलरली अगर मैं आपसे पूछूं बेंजीन की मोल फ्रैक्शन टॉप प्रोडक्ट में क्या है, तो आप 593.53 को 931 से डिवाइड कर देंगे। सिमिलरली अगर मैं आपसे मोल में पूछूँ कि बेंजीन की मोल फ्रैक्शन क्या है टॉप प्रोडक्ट में, तो 7.59 को 11.2668 से डिवाइड कर देंगे। तो ये इस तरह से भी आपसे पूछा जा सकता है, या इवन आपको डायग्राम दी जा सकते हैं। इंडस्ट्री के लेवल पे भी ऐसा हो सकता है कि आपसे इंटरव्यू में कह दिया जाए कि ये डायग्राम आपके पास पड़ी है, आप इससे हमें मास फ्रैक्शन या मोल फ्रैक्शन निकाल के दिखाएं। यू हैव बीन आस्क्ड इन इंडस्ट्रियल इंटरव्यूज एज वेल दैट यू हैव बीन गिवन दिस डायग्राम एंड कैलकुलेट द मास फ्रैक्शंस और टेल अस व्हाट इज द मास फ्लो ऑफ बेंजीन इन टॉप और बॉटम प्रोडक्ट। सिमिलरली द मास फ्रैक्शंस आर अवेलेबल ओवर हियर। सो इफ आई टेक यू बैक टू मेन शीट एंड क्लिक ऑन रिजल्ट्स, then you see the outlet temperature 70 degree centigrade of the stream which is exiting the flash separator, or at the outlet of flash separator the outlet pressure, the vapor fraction in mole and in mass, the heat duty you can take it to kilowatt, it's 101.669, and same is the case for net duty, which is also the same. So that's our first activity, that we have used flash separator to separate a benzene toluene mixer. It was quite straightforward, but the next activity is a bit tricky. So let's quickly go to that activity, and you can even close it down, because in next activity our mixer will be different. So this activity, the objective is same as that of the previous activity, but in problem description we have been asked to find the bubble pressure of liquid phase, the pressure at which first drop of vapor starts, means the liquid starts boiling, of liquid phase of pentane hexane mixture with the specific composition using Pang-Robinson property method. We have used this mixer in stream splitter as well. 2000 kg per hour of feed supply at the same conditions, 70 degree centigrade, 50 weight percent pentane and 50 weight percent hexane. And since it's a liquid phase, so obviously we will be getting only liquid. We will not be getting vapor because it just starts boiling. It's at saturated liquid line. The mixer is at saturated liquid line where it just starts boiling. So we will obtain vapor. And if you want to study it, you can go to TXY diagram, which we have discussed. So again, degree of freedom is 2, as we have discussed. But in this case, we will specify temperature, which is same as that of the feed. However, we can't specify pressure because we need to calculate the bubble pressure. So what should we define? We do not have any idea about heat duty because it is not given. But we have been asked that it is in liquid state. So remember, for liquid phases, the vapor fraction is 0. And for our vapor phases, this vapor fraction is 1. So pentane 50 weight percent, hexane 50 weight percent, mass fraction given, total mass flow rate is 2000 kg per hour, feed temperature is 70 degree centigrade, feed pressure is 1 bar, and we have to specify in flash separator, vapor fraction is 0, and temperature is same as that of the feed. So what we do, same pentane hexane mixer selected, pangrobenzene selected, then specify the conditions over here. Specify 70 degree centigrade and 0 as vapor fraction. And after running it, you see that only liquid is produced. This feed, which is in liquid state, and bottom means the in liquid state, and up means vapor, no vapor is produced. And you see the temperature or the outlet temperature is 70 degree centigrade, outlet pressure is 1.98931, and this heat duty. And now it is in negative. So think about it. Why it is negative in this case and why it was positive in the previous case. We will discuss it in our interaction session as well. So let's go back to Aspen Plus and do it quickly. Pentane, hexane components, click next. Pangrobenzene, click run, and results are available without any warning. Go to simulation again, select this flash separator, add it over here and limit as flash, expand it, and then do the required connections of material stream, which is the feed stream in vapor, specify it as vapor, liquid, specify it as liquid, and then feed, it's 70 degree centigrade, 1 bar, mass flow rate as 2000 kg per hour, with mass fraction of pentane and heptane as 0.5 each. Click next. Temperature value is 70 degree centigrade, and in pressure change it to vapor fraction, and vapor fraction is 0, and then run it. If you specify it more than 0, means if you specify it 0.01 as well, then you see liquid will be produced, but a small quantity of vapor will be produced as well. Go to main flow sheet in flash, click on stream results, and you see no vapor is produced. And the pressure, which is the bubble point pressure, is approximately 2 bar, or I can say it as 1.98931 bar at same temperature, which is 70 degree centigrade. Now, if I give you this condition, then you must be able to recognize that you have not given the pressure as 1.98931, it is the calculated pressure, and you have given the vapor fraction, which is 0 at the outlet. 70 degree centigrade, 1 bar, inlet temperature pressure respectively, 70 degree centigrade and 1.98931 bar as outlet temperature pressure respectively for liquid. The feed was in vapor phase and now it is condensed. It means heat is released. That is why, if I take you to this flash results, this heat duty is negative. And in previous case, it was positive. So I have given you a bit indication that why it was negative. Once you come it down, the mole fraction will remain the same. The mole flows will remain the same. The mass fraction will remain the same because your objective was to determine the bubble point. That's how you do flash separator simulation. You can even determine the bubble point temperature. How? by specifying pressure as 1 bar and ask Espen to calculate bubble temperature for you. So that's all from this activity. Thank you so much. Till then, it's goodbye.